I was kind of finding my way down the stairs one evening, or one night, and I suddenly felt myself just sort of falling off the stairs and down to the bottom level of the house.
Today on Behind the Mystery, we're talking to Keith, his wife Linda, and how they're living with neurogenic orthostatic hypotension, or NOH. Never heard of it? Well, let's start with the basics. N, neurogenic, associated with the nervous system. O, orthostatic, related to standing up. H, hypotension, abnormally low blood pressure. In the studio this morning to help us understand this condition is neurologist Dr. Stuart Isaacson. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for being here. We're going to hear from Keith and his wife Linda in just a bit, but first let's talk about what is NOH. I've never heard of it.
Well, NOH, as you just pointed out, is neurogenic orthostatic hypotension. And it's a condition that's not very common, but occurs in people who have Parkinson's disease and some related conditions called multiple system atrophy. And the problem with NOH is usually when we stand up, we release a chemical called norepinephrine. And this causes the blood vessels to constrict and the heart to beat faster. So blood pressure comes up and we don't feel like the blood pressure is dropping. We don't have feelings of lightheadedness or dizziness. Many people with Parkinson's disease, probably about 1 in 5 have symptoms from NOH. And when they stand up, not enough norepinephrine is released and the blood pressure goes down and down. And they begin to develop lightheadedness and dizziness, and they might even pass out.
So in terms of how many people are affected, it's 1 in 5.
1 in 5 will have symptoms, and these may be provoked by dehydration or not feeling well or taking medication that may lower blood pressure. And then when symptoms come out, we have to pay attention to the symptoms. And one way we do this is we have people check their blood pressure. They can check it in the visit when they come to our office. They can check it at home. Often after breakfast might be a time of day when it's the lowest. They can keep a diary of how it changes around mealtime or after meals or when they're lying in bed at night. And when we find the blood pressure drops, we always look for a key point, which is at the heart rate. Usually when blood pressure falls and someone feels lightheaded, the heart rate goes up and up and up. But in neurogenic orthostatic hypotension, in NOH, the heart rate doesn't change much at all. And that's really a key for a doctor and nurse to make the diagnosis of NOH.
We recently spent the day with Keith, who has Parkinson's, and his wife, Linda. His diagnosis of NOH came several years into the onset of Parkinson's. Let's hear more.
I think he had a little trouble.
Do you want some more coffee?
Sure.
A little bit of fruit?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was 10 years after his Parkinson's diagnosis that Keith and his wife Linda noticed signs and symptoms of what would eventually be diagnosed as NOH. Episodes were sporadic.
You know, kind of stumbling as after being in a car ride or going up a set of steps. Why, you know, why all of a sudden would you be dizzy?
That was the time when we thought it was just a periodic event that was happening every now and then.
The NOH diagnosis was a little bit more difficult because initially I just thought it was the other shoe that fell off with Parkinson's. Keith had a couple falls, not just down the steps, but a couple general falls, like, okay, does this mean this is what happens with Parkinson's? And we had been educated enough that to know that everybody is different. So we were also very fortunate that our general practitioner and our movement specialist spoke to each other. So between the two of them came up with, okay, we've got some blood pressure issues here.
Keith, a former pilot and self-described gym rat, has learned to manage his NOH symptoms. He makes sure to drink more water along with other lifestyle changes as recommended by his doctor.
The enemy is impatience, that sometimes you're in a situation where you don't know how severe your episode's going to be. And so I now have a routine where I get up and I give the blood a chance to kind of, and the blood pressure to equalize. And I've been able to avoid any mishaps, just following a simple, you know, set of rules.
They keep a blood pressure log and communicate regularly with their healthcare team.
Communication with your doctor is extremely important.
College sweethearts, the Halls have always been an on-the-go family. They're taking steps to help ensure they continue to stay active, even with Keith's Parkinson's and nOH.
When Keith's first initial diagnosis, to me, it wasn't devastating. I've always taken aback when people say that. So to us, it was just part of what our journey was going to be. It might be tiring, but I think to have things move smoothly, and you do have to think about everything. So if you are traveling or you're going out, you make sure that you have your snacks and your water and your glasses. And it's just part of who we are and what we're doing.
And they're committed to spreading awareness.
I think the best thing is to look into what your local resources are. Support groups can be wonderful, but they also cannot be for everyone. Finding classes that you can either do together or finding your own thing that you can do.
Now, doctor, while you're not Keith's physician, can you relate this to how your experience has been with your patients?
Well, I think what we heard from Keith and his wife are that these symptoms come on very gradually. It's hard to sometimes recognize that they're new symptoms. He's had symptoms of Parkinson's for several years, where he's had trouble maybe arising from a chair and walking and having good balance and movement. And now different symptoms may occur that can be confused with the mobility problems of Parkinson's. So it's important when you have any types of symptoms, standing or after a meal, to bring those up at a visit with the doctor and nurse and talk about how the symptoms may be different and may be early symptoms of nOH.
Now, doctor, once properly diagnosed, are there ways to manage nOH symptoms?
When they stand up, they should do it gradually. Sit at the side of the bed for a couple of minutes, then stand up, and before they walk, wait a couple of minutes. Sometimes squeezing the calf muscles or the gluteal muscles can help maintain blood pressure when they stand up as well. Some of our patients wear compression stockings, usually up to the waist, so it can really push the blood back from the stomach and also the legs. We tell our patients to remain well hydrated, to really concentrate on drinking a lot of water and other fluids and adding salt to their diet, especially drinking those fluids in the morning hours when blood pressure is lower. Some of our patients elevate the head of the bed when they sleep. And when they don't work, we have medications that can help as well. Our patients always have to talk with their doctors and nurses to make sure that whatever they're anticipating to do to try to treat this problem is done with medical guidance.
It's manageable, and that you can modify the response that you have to the nOH by being patient. You can live with it, and you can do well with it.
So, doctor, to summarize everything, what are the key things we need to remember here?
Well, I think it's important to realize that nOH is very common in Parkinson's disease, even more common in multiple system atrophy. And so whenever you have symptoms that occur when you stand up, always think that it could be a symptom of nOH and bring it up at the next visit with your doctor or nurse. And to make the diagnosis, the blood pressure has to be checked seated and also standing with the heart rate and make that diagnosis, because the diagnosis has to be made so we can use effective management to try to improve the symptoms and not have people doing less and less activity, becoming isolated, becoming depressed, not going out and going about their day because the blood pressure is too low.
Doctor, thank you so much for your time and all the information you've given us today.
Sure, thank you.
And if you'd like more information on nOH, you can go to this website, nohmatters.com, or just check out our website, thebalancingact.com.